नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मैं प्रेम एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर सिटिंग विद अस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड थ्रू नित्यानंदा टीवी, लोटस न्यूज चैनल, साधना टीवी एंड टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग हैविंग नयन दीक्षा सिटी सिटिंग विद अस इन टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग हैविंग नयन दीक्षा हांगकांग सीरगाड़ी देवोन यूके पोर्ट वाशिंगटन न्यूयॉर्क सिंगापुर सिंगापुरम ओमन शिवगंगई डेकोटा कोलंबिया ओहायो मा शिवानंद ईस्ट लंडन यूके सैंडियागो पसिफिक बीच तिरुवान्मियूर चेन्नई दुबाई वैद्यनाथम हैदराबाद गुप्तकाशी ओमन शिवगंगई टोरंटो कैलासम सरे ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया सिंगापुर सिंगापुरम ओहायो चिनो हिल्स कैलिफोर्निया ग्वाडलूप रामेश्वरम कुआलालंपुर पळनी ह्यूस्टन लॉस एंजेलिस ओक्लाहोमा सियाटल ओहायो प्रयाग सरे ब्रिटिश कोलंबिया चार्लेट टोरंटो वाराणसी पेरिस होम टेंपल नित्यानंद सैक्रेड आर्ट सिटी जोरपाटी काठमांडू। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विथ माय लव एंड ब्लेसिंग्स। टुडे आई विल एक्सपैंड ऑन द रिजल्ट्स एंड बेनिफिट्स ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग दिस फोर तत्वस इनटू योर बीइंग internalization of four tattvas, what it can cause to you. Please understand, come to the space of listening. I am defining suffering. Suffering is nothing but the fight between the frozen part of you and the flowing component of life. Please listen. Suffering is nothing but the fight between the frozen part of you and the flowing component of life. Life, by its very nature, alive, active, flowing. But your logic, by its very nature, frozen, cold, insensitive. And do you know very funny thing? Your logic will be insensitive to life, but it will always make you believe life is insensitive to you. All right, it is the truth, okay. Part of us is frozen and that fights with the life. And so the suffering happens, that fight is the suffering. What is the way to get out of this suffering? What is the way to end the war? Every war will end only with an agreement, with a settlement, with a pact. Settlement agreement. I tell you, the only settlement agreement which can end the war in your life is four principles. Integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching. Listen. Dhyan se suniye. Listen. Listen sincerely. Listen in the space of listening. when you bring integrity in your thinking, authenticity in your actions, responsibility in your being, enriching in your life, you are frozen inside, melts down, starts becoming one with life. It becomes part of the life. Becoming part of the life is what I call enlightenment. Just becoming part of the life is what I call enlightenment. Sometimes people tell me, I don't want spiritual life. I don't want these four tattvas. It is like telling, I don't want to breathe. I don't want blood circulation. Then what to do? You need to understand there is no such thing as spiritual life and normal life. Life is life is a life is a life. Life is a life is a life is a life. Please listen. When it is frozen and carries a lot of suffering in body and mind, it is, you can call that as a normal life. When a lot of your frozen components melts down and you are able to flow with the life beautifully, I tell you, if you have the frozen part of you only to the level of boat, that is okay. The boat can float on the life. But when the frozen part becomes one third of the river itself blocked in you. Understand? A ice bar can be floating on the river. Nothing wrong. Even if you have a little resistance, only to the level of ice bar, ice cube, you can float on the river. But if your resistance is like a frozen river, the river itself is blocked. I have seen sometime this huge frozen ice becomes even a barrier for the river to flow. 75% of the water will be stuck. Only 10-20% water goes beyond that ice cube, icebergs. If your life is frozen to that level, then even life cannot happen through you. So first thing you need is four tattvas. It is a simple principles like a breathing and eating. Mix integrity with your breathing, authenticity with your eating, responsibility with your blood circulation, enriching with your actions. Understand, all four are directly connected. When you start thinking with integrity, your breathing will become beautiful and best. That is the best pranayama you can do. Thinking with integrity is the best pranayama. That's the result of all pranayamas. What is pranayama? Some part of you doesn't get enough of oxygen. Your brain needs to get certain level of oxygen. Your heart needs to get certain level of oxygen. Your blood circulation needs to carry certain level of oxygen to all the parts of your body. Your body getting a proper oxygen supply is the purpose of pranayama. Purpose of pranayama is achieved if your whole body gets enough supply of oxygen. I have seen some brains, only brain gets oxygen, no other heart doesn't get oxygen, any other component, any other part of their body doesn't get oxygen. And same way, some people, only heart gets oxygen, brain has no function. For some people, only their private parts gets oxygen, nothing else gets oxygen. For some people, now this is, these are the different type of people, different type of life. So pranayama is needed to balance and enrich the whole body with enough prana energy. If you think with integrity, that will happen. If you think with integrity, that will happen. Listen. If you think with integrity, that will happen. Integrity will melt down all the blockages you carry in your breathing pattern. I can tell you, the physical result of integrity is all your breath related, the air circulation related, breathing related problems will disappear. And it will bring a lot of courage in your thinking. Please understand. Listen, I am making a very important statement. Most of your sufferings are because you are afraid to think about some parts of your life, some components of your life. You are afraid of thinking. You always think because you are thinking, you are getting fear. No, you are actually afraid of thinking. That is why those thoughts may cause fear in you. You think, then you stop thinking. Listen, I am giving you the example. You think, if you think about ghost, you will have fear. But I tell you, because you are afraid to think about the ghost and its side effects and after effects, you are suffering. It is not that because you think about ghost you are suffering, because you are afraid to think about ghost and its after effects, you are suffering. Fear of thinking. And you also need to know, thinking about the ghost and its after effects is not going to bring that effect on you. Thinking about the fire and its after effects is not going to burn your body. When you have that clarity, you will know how not to be afraid of thinking. Please listen. When you are not having any fear to think about ghost and its after effects, you will never think about ghost and have fear. Please get it. I am unlocking one of the important self-doubting structures of your being. Please understand. I am giving you the formulas of life algebra. See, sometimes there will be a knot with which you are caught. You do not know where it starts and where it ends and how to unlock. This is one of the important knot. If you think, when you think about the ghost, you are frightened, shaken, so you should not think about ghost, you are wrong. You are not getting the fear because you think. You are getting the fear because you don't want to think. And when you have the fear because you don't want to think, that knot will continue to remind you which you don't want to think. It is like you don't want to think about ghost. Then what you will be doing whole day? You will be thinking you don't want to think about ghost. It is like doctor telling you don't remember the monkey and drink this medicine. Can you ever drink that medicine? No. The moment you want to drink the medicine, monkey is there in front of you and inside you. Listen. So, ironing out your inner space And liberating yourself from fear of thinking is integrity. Understand, I am defining integrity. When you practice integrity, you will be free from fear of thinking. You can nicely, comfortably sit and you will be able to think, if ghost comes, what will happen? What all is possibility? It may just snatch my one hand and may eat. And if it doesn't feel satisfied, it may just pluck my one leg and it may eat. Then what else? If you are able to get to the extreme of any thinking logically without the fear or resistance, I tell you, that flow of thinking will not even happen in you second time. Listen, I am giving you an example. If you are afraid of ghost, there are some people who are afraid of disease. There are some people who are afraid of jail. There are some people who are afraid of poverty. About whatever you are afraid, sit and in a very cool way, comfortable way, know very clearly, because you are thinking, you are not going to have it. Millions of things which you thought, you did not have it. You always wanted private jet. Did you have? No. You always wanted this. Did you get it? No. So know it very clearly. Mere thinking is never going to get you that result. Only creating a space is going to get you the result. Creating the space means taking the responsibility along with thinking. So sit very clearly and comfortably. Now I am going to merely allow myself to think to the extreme conclusions, the logical conclusions of any thought trend about which I am afraid of. If I am afraid of poverty, let me sit and think about the extreme possibility of poverty. If I am afraid of being in jail, let me sit and think the extreme possibility of being in jail. If I am afraid of death, let me sit and think the extreme possibility of death. If I am afraid of any disease, let me sit and think the extreme possibility of disease. Listen, the fear of thinking does not let you think beyond certain limit. Then that does not mean that fear is going to make you forget about that subject completely. For example, if you are afraid of a disease and you don't think logically extreme end of the disease, it is not that your inner space will never remember about the disease. Logically you will not think, but unconsciously you will be brooding over. I tell you, anything which stays in your unconscious as a weight and makes you brood over, bring all of them out and consciously think through to the logical conclusion. With integrity, fear of thinking will disappear. And once the fear of thinking disappears, thinking can't cause fear to you. Please understand, as per the mutual law of Dhamma, please listen, cosmos functions with the law. Don't give it to others what should not be given to you. Don't give it to others what should not be given to you. If you don't give it to others what should not be given to you, what should not be given to you will not be given to you by others. इट्स कॉस्मिक लॉ ऑफ लाइफ. लिसन प्लीज इंटरनलाइज. व्हेन यू डोंट हैव फियर ऑफ थिंकिंग, थिंकिंग विल नॉट गिव फियर टू यू. इट विल नॉट हैव फियर ऑफ यू. बोथ ऑफ यू, यू एंड यूर थिंकिंग कम टू अ वॉर अग्रीमेंट. टिल टूडे वी हैड अ वॉर, लेट अस स्टॉप द वॉर. लेट अस कम टू द अग्रीमेंट, व्हाट यू कॉल सीज फायर. लेट्स कम टू सीज फायर टूडे. आई विल नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ यू, यू नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ मी. दैट अग्रीमेंट इज व्हाट आई कॉल इंटेग्रिटी. You not having fear of thinking and thinking not having fear of you, the agreement is integrity. Please understand. So first thing you need to do in your life is sit and think about all the subjects, dimensions, space and happenings of your life which you are not interested in thinking, about which you are afraid of thinking. If you are afraid of poverty, you have to sit and think what all can be the logical conclusion and effects of my poverty, about which I am afraid, about which I don't want to think. Sit and think. I am not saying bring that poverty to you. No. I am just saying think. In few days, I tell you, just in few days, it may not take more than 3-4 days, your fear of poverty will dissolve. Please listen. Whenever you do not have fear of thinking something, that will not continue to haunt you and sit in your unconsciousness as weight in your hair. So people who have the matted lock hairstyle, the Shiva Jata hairstyle, actually even the 3-4 matted lock is equivalent to the normal person's thickest hair. Because if you open the matted lock and make it into a normal hair, it will be 10 times more voluminous. Please listen, understand this example. Actually 200 hair, whatever area it occupies in your head, if it becomes matted lock, it will occupy only 1/10 of that place, the strands of hair, because it becomes very thick. Same way, the brooding over is a thickened thought trend. If you are afraid of poverty and never iron out by logically thinking about it, that will sit in you like a knot, like a strand of the hair. Strand of the hair is a thick hair. Same way, the part which sits in you, which you don't want to think, but continues to sit in you and attracts your attention, that swallows your energy. Please listen. If you are afraid of poverty, doesn't want to think about it logically, it is not that you are not going to think about poverty. You will be constantly afraid of poverty and brooding over poverty, unconsciously wasting all your energy, because that is going to be sitting in your lungs, in your heart, as a big tumor. In your unconscious space, as a big tumor. Ironing out your thinking and not afraid of thinking about anything taking any thinking to the logical conclusion is integrity. Please listen. Whenever you want to think about poverty, death, fear, jail, you are always afraid. If you think about all that, it may come in your life. But whenever you want to think about richness, getting your desires fulfilled, you always have fear, even if I think I will not get it. See the funny way your brain functions. All the things you want, you always think you are not going to get it. All the things you don't want, you always think, even by thinking you will get it. See, all the things you want in your life, you always think you won't get it even if you work for it. All the things you don't want in your life, you always think you will get it even if you think about it. Life is not that unfair with you. Whatever happens in your life happens only after you think and take responsibility for it. The ghost will happen in your life if you take the responsibility of inviting it. Poverty will happen in your life only when you take the responsibility of inviting it. Please listen. Anything happens when you take the responsibility of inviting it, making it happen. You should know very clearly. You should see your own hypocrisy, which you don't want in your life, you feel even if you think it will come. Which you always want in your life, you think even if you work for it, it will not come. What a funny belief space we create about life. And then go on blaming life. If you create this kind of space, how will the life respond to you? Ironing out your thinking. Logical flow of your thinking need to be done as the first step of your life. First thing you need to do today, sit and list out all the zones you are afraid of. If you are afraid of disease, first disease, then next death, third jail, fourth poverty, fifth losing all the relationships, sixth living the life of aloneliness, seventh living the life of being unattended, third living the life without having any attention. What all you are afraid of? There are some people who have the fear living the life of losing the mental balance, being mad. Whatever fear you have, write it and logically sit and think about it. When you lose fear of thinking, thinking loses fear of you. When both of you lose fear of each other, you live happily, blissfully, married together forever. You live happily ever after. Having eternal romance with your thinking is integrity. Integrity takes away the fear component in your thinking. You can think about anything. You will take responsibility for the right thing. You will think about anything, you will take responsibility for right thing. You will not have this perverted faith about you and your own life. Please understand, the perverted faith is, whatever you don't want, you are always afraid, even if you think it will happen in you. Whatever you want, you are always afraid, even if you take responsibility, it will not be given to you. It is the perverted reception to life. See, it is like You wanted some highly respected, honored guests to come to your house. But the moment they are entering your house, you stand there with your shoes in your hand, your son is standing with a broomstick, and the another one is standing with a water with cow dung. How is the guest is going to come into your house? And etc. etc. This is what I call perverted reception. Same way, when life enters into you, you are sitting completely abusing, firing, grumbling, grudging. I know you will give what I don't want, even if I think. I know you won't give what I want, even if I work for it. Ironing out your thinking is integrity. Bringing authenticity in your actions. That is the second component of life. Please listen. Whenever you bring authenticity in your life, in your actions, please listen. Whenever you bring authenticity in your actions, your continuous enmity with actions melts down, your life becomes active. You need to know a very basic thing. Life is happening. It is not noun, it is a verb. Life is a happening. One of the worst thing happened to humanity is watching sports. Sports is supposed to be done by you. Playing is supposed to be done by you. One well-known fool in the village, the neighbor was asking him, in the conversation, about so many things. The conversation was happening. The neighbor was telling, have you heard recently one big disease called HIV? It is getting really, really bad. Lot of people are suffering. This neighbor said, I spoke to one of my friend, how is he protecting himself from it? He told me, he completely keeps himself away from all physical contact. Kovalu said, that is too bad. The friend said, I spoke to another one friend. He said he completely protects himself during all physical contact. Koala said, that looks little intelligent. Suddenly Koala exclaimed, but I have got the best solution. The friend was really curious. What better solution can be there other than these two? Completely keeping yourself away or protecting yourself. What else can be the best solution? The friend was surprised and asked the Kovalu, what is your solution? I hire somebody else to do it. Please understand, most of our life goes not being active, and you continues to imagine. By not being active, you can taste life. Whether it is right or wrong, only when you are active, life starts happening in you. Innate incompletions you carry with the quality of being active. all of us as a child have been controlled by our parents and society and elders when we are active, because they can't handle it. They control. When you jump, scream, scroll, or whirl, and I can use all sorts of word, howl. When you do all that, scream, the elders control you because they can't handle you. And unfortunately, you carry the deep incompletion in you, not respected or allowed to be active. So you start hating being active, and that becomes a very strong pattern, incompletion in you. Please understand, if you have been suppressed while you are whirling as a child and you still carry the incompletion, you can't even do simple yogasana without back pain. You have to complete with all the situations where you are being controlled for being active, the incompletions you made for being active. A child should not carry any incompletions about being active. And because you carry incompletions about being active, you lose authenticity. Please listen. Authenticity is directly related to food and the fire in your stomach. If you bring authenticity, the fire in the stomach will become alive again. If the fire in the stomach is alive again, you will become authentic. Authenticity is nothing but completing with your incompletions with being active. The incompletions you carry towards being active is inauthenticity. The straight way to bring authenticity in your life is complete with all the incompletions you have about being active. About being active, listen, it is most unfortunate thing happens to human being throughout, all over the world, in all countries, all civilizations, in all societies. It is unfortunate. The parents are not able to handle the kids being active. They are being controlled, and the kids develop incompletion about being active. Kids start developing, if they are active, something is wrong, that kind of a pattern. Incompletion becomes so much. If they are active, it is wrong. I tell you, if you complete the incompletions with being active, first thing will happen to you. You will be surprised. First thing will happen to you, your lust will melt down. Because lust is nothing but secretly trying to be active. Because you believe being active is not right. The side effect of the incompletions with being active is lust. If you complete with the incompletions of being active, if you bring authenticity, the first effect in your life is it will melt down all the lust. Second, the fire of Agni will become awakened. Your body will become pure, shining. If the body is not shining, I can be 120% sure that person is not celibate, even if he is a monk. If somebody is a monk, somebody is celibate, authentically the body will become shining. Authenticity. Authenticity is nothing but completing with the pattern of being active. Complete all the incompletions you carry in your life because of being active. Bring yourself to the space of being complete with being active. Go back to all the incompletions created in you, in your childhood, by you and by others. One thing, others can only be the maximum cause, but you only create. Incompletions cannot be created by others in you. You only create. Others may be a circumstantial cause. If I have to put a little better word, they may be just a circumstance. But the incompletion itself is created by you. It is created by you. As long as you carry incompletions about being active, the active lifestyle will bring so much of pain and hatred and suffering in you. You will hate being active. And you know, funny thing, when you are not active, naturally the fire in the stomach will be dead. When you are not active, you are taking the responsibility to bring diseases into your body. It is like, when you are not active, when you are not authentic, you give invitation to all the diseases. When they come to you, you say, no, I did not call you. What is this? You guys are suddenly here. Get out. They say, no, once we receive invitation, we don't cancel our booking. We have to visit your house and we have to be there with you for some time. We have to spend time with you. Being active. Completing all the incompletions with being active is authenticity. Authenticity is happily marrying, being active, and happily living ever after. Please listen. Being responsible is being complete with your being. Being enriching is being complete with your life itself. How they are connected? Watch tomorrow's satsang.
Inner awakening, running health recoveries, 100% cure for depression, insomnia, asthma, fatigue, chronic pain, insecurity, panic attacks, and other major disorders. Awaken the Kundalini Shakti, the dormant energy within. What would you do if you had 1300% more energy? Disease-free mind and body is your first wealth. Claim it at Inner Awakening. Inner Awakening, a 21-day meditation retreat with rare living incarnation. Paramahamsa Nityananda, Nityananda Dhyanapita, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Contact 0802-727-9999. Email ia@nityananda.org.
Jeevan Mukti Pradam Devam.
Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored in Tamil and English more than 500 books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, schools, ashrams, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. Bidadi, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai, Salem, Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Ohio,
वंशदीप्तारं नैकदीक्षा प्रदायकं वंदे वाक्यमनातीतं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं सन्यास वंशदीप्तारं नैकदीक्षा प्रदायकं वंदे वाक्यमनातीतं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं जीवन मुक्ति प्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहं साख्यं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं जीवन मुक्ति प्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहं साख्यं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share and explode in eternal bliss.
நித்யானந்த தியானபீடம் நித்யானந்த நகர் ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட் பிடதி பெங்களூரு ஃபோன் 08027279999 www.nithyananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation